let's go.
It's like my new metal intro.
Let's.
What's up? I was just wearing a hat. This is Lockdown Hair Nice Live. Broadcasting inspiration. Screaming into the void. No rules, all heart. I'm Ricky Reed, record producer, artist, dad. All around person. Sorry, I couldn't figure out how to land that. Took off a hat seconds ago, so this is what you got. This is what we're working with. Hello to everyone in the damn chat. We are 29 lives in. Nice lives. Gotta stop saying that like that. 29 of these. Whew. Wow. That's a month of days. I think I said that last week, but I'm also in the chat with my official name. Check me out. I'm in the chat now, so I can drop it. I'm gonna drop an emoji in the chat. Do I play Xbox, PS4, Switch, or PC? Sorry, if I had time to play any video games, I would buy one of those like little Super NESs that are like this big and like play the OG games. That's all I can do. I'm dropping a, what's the worst emoji I can drop in the chat? There it is. Done. And I'm wrenched up. Let me just check in with my co-host one time. Usual shit. Let me see if we can know you. So, boy, where are we at? It's been a week. I am kind of buzzing on the fact that I released music this week. I'm assuming you guys were all here on Monday. The big announce, Real Magic, came out Monday with Saint Panther and Terrace Martin. It's my first single from my first album as a solo artist. The album's called The Room. Gonna talk about why it's called The Room more soon, but that was Monday. That was a fun night. I'm keeping the drinking actually a little bit minimal tonight because I kind of went in a little on Monday, so I'm taking it easy a little more tonight. I'm buzzing on the high of having released music, but I'm trying to also keep my adrenals and my excitement in check a little bit, because I know that it feels really great to do something like put out music or any piece of art or just any project you're excited about. But it's easy to get carried away with the rush of it, and be like refreshing your socials all the time and be like, oh, like, you know, you got to be in there, you got to be promoting, but also and working, but you also, like, if you're not careful, you can ride it a little too hard and you can crash. And I've really done that before. So finding balance, I think, to me, has always been about obviously trying to avoid low lows, but part of avoiding low lows is not letting yourself get swept off your feet to a degree of being unhealthy, which can happen. That can happen. So let's talk. It was an exciting couple days. Real Magic, the video dropped also. We're getting some playlist love. Super excited. All kinds of cool things. Got some cool shout outs going on for the record. Also, I uploaded the stems to Audius. You may have seen I posted a thing today about that where want you guys to go download the stems. I know we have a shit ton of producers that watch this. We have some sick producers because I've heard some of the stuff you guys have done now. So we're encouraging, if you can, go to Audius, download the stems, upload a remix there, send it to us, tag us, whatever, however it works. And I'm going to pick my favorite remix and bring somebody as a guest on the damn stream. It's going to be tight. I think it'd be really fun. I like mixing it up with you guys, and I'd like to see what you do. Also, we do encourage covers of anything that I make. And I got to give a big shout out. Let me see if she's in the chat. You guys are talking about Sonic the Hedgehog. What is going on? I can leave you guys for 1 second. She is Czar. Czar is an OG from the chat. One of the people that's been with us from the beginning. She recorded an amazing piano vocal cover of Real Magic that me and Terrace and St. Panther all shared back and forth with each other today. Just blown away by that, Czar. So thank you. Amazing voice. Great arrangement. Go check it out. Czar, drop your IG handle in the chat, because I want people to go check it out. You killed it. It's great. Jeremy Jackson, I'm going to just drop this one here. It's very hard to tweak such a great song with super fun to work on. Thanks, dude. You know, I think the big thing with when you dig a song chordally, melodically, etc., you're trying to figure out where to take it for a remix. Think about rhythm. That's a good place to start. The song is fast. What does it feel like slow? It's 70 BPM / 140 BPM. What's the halfway between 70 and 140? Like 105 or something. What does it sound like at 105? You know, can I put triplets in it? Just like basic things. I think thinking about rhythm is a good way to start. I also think with remixes, it's fun to just play in the sandbox, play with new sounds. You know, a good remix to me sounds like the person making it had fun. That's the way I think about it. So, speaking of remixes, we're going to bring in a special guest tonight who is just one of the legit OGs. I don't know if he considers himself an OG. He is truly now an OG, not just of remixing, but tastemaker, label head, and somebody who I've actually modeled a lot of my career, my path, my trajectory after. I'm super stoked to have him on the show. I'm going to geek out about a few things, and I want you guys to get some questions ready. I'm going to bring him out. This is Nick Catchdubs. What up, dude?
Hey, what's happening?
How you doing?
Feeling good.
Good. Good. I like the smiley face behind you.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Beautiful. You know what I didn't do? I forgot to do this before I brought you on, so I'll do it here live with you. I always ask people how they're feeling on a scale of 1 to 10. Include the decimal point. Today, I'm sort of buzz chat. Let me know how you're feeling. Nick, where are you at today, dude?
I feel pretty positive. I feel like I'm in that 8 zone. A-Track and I joke about how, like, when we check in with people, it's not so much like a how you're doing, but more like, you know, let me check your vitals.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Safe, stable.
Yeah, it's all proof of life at this point.
Yep. No, completely. Like, wow. So we got a 9.99 in the chat. Congratulations.
Nice. They're
love
feeling
to see
it.
That. Oh shit! A-Track's in the chat, dude.
Love it.
Wow. What's up, bro? Very, very cool. We got you guys are both a couple of legends. I mean, Fool's Gold, when I was coming up in wallpaper, everything that you guys put out, from some of the things that had like big hits like Duck Sauce to guys that I eventually met and played shows with like Treasure Fingers. I mean, such a crazy, crazy list of stuff. I didn't realize that you guys were sort of the first to give Cudi one of his first looks. Is that right?
Yeah, we put out the Day and Night single.
That's too... That is, like, too crazy to just say that nonchalantly. I mean, that is
But to be real, you know, I think that all of our best work and our biggest successes have come from, you know, not a place of being naive, but a place of just being, you know, honest and authentic. Like, you know, when we work with people, you know, the stuff that really connects is the stuff where we were friends first, you know, mm-hmm. The stuff where we were like, oh, you know, this is something that's happening in our, you know, musical world. Like, you know, right. People like to use like phrases like organic and community, and it's really corny and marketing.
Right.
But the reality is that if you are part of a creative community, and if you are part of a genuine, you know, scene of people, there's lots of really cool stuff that can happen from that. You know, you just have to stay tuned in. And I think that it's really cool that, you know, 13 years in, the same instincts that led us to, you know, guys like Cudi and Treasure Fingers are leading us to artists like, you know, DJ Swisha and Tabby Wakes and, you know, people in New York and all over the world who are just doing stuff that's like a little bit tweaked and a little bit different. And right. We can just provide a platform for that.
Right. I mean, the funny thing about it is, and this is why you guys were so influential to me when I was coming up, is the lens with which you see the music that you love and discover and eventually put on, I've always felt like a kinship to, because there's a little bit of a pop appeal in the things that you guys gravitate towards. It's like there's, when I think of some of the great Fool's Gold releases, I think of things that are both new and unique and sort of like tweak the ear, but also are tend to be immediately pleasing. Just like feel, like records that feel really good. I want to ask you about a record that actually doesn't, that some may not say feels good, but was one of my top five albums of all time. Triple X, Danny Brown. So I want you to tell me, I mean, I could ask a zillion questions about it, but how did you get connected with him? What was it like putting that album together? Like, give me the super fan story that I've been waiting for.
Well, the cool thing about, you know, Danny's record was that, you know, here's an artist that has, you know, been making music and really kind of refining who they are. You know what I mean? Like, I think a lot of artists, you know, have that spark, or, you know, what you might call, like, they've got it. They've got, you know, they've got that magic quality. And right. I'm not downing that in any way. Like, that's a legit thing that a successful artist needs to have. Totally. But also too, you know, as you make art and as you discover who you are, you know, that's a record about a guy, you know, looking at 30 and really sort of understanding who he is and what he wants to express creatively. Mm-hmm. So on one hand, you know, the art of that record is really pure and interesting and has such a great defined point of view, mm-hmm. that, you know, the way that it came to us was just through like this, you know, weird circuit of friends, you know, like I had been following the, you know, the self-release stuff and the sort of circuit of, you know, just indie things that Danny had been doing on his own, right. You know, in Detroit and like, you know, the tentacles first starting to hit the internet. But, you know, a friend of mine happened to be managing him at the time. And we ran into one another literally at a taco place in Williamsburg one night, particularly late at night. And he was like, yo, you know, I'm working with the guy, Danny Brown. And I was like, I know you are. I fuck with Danny. Like, he's awesome. Like, let's keep this conversation rolling. So, you know, the fact that it came from, you know, an existing awareness, like a lot of times, you know, when people who, you know, mm-hmm. hit you up, or, and I'm sure you get this, you know, the sort of the idea of networking,
right?
The reality is that, you know, there's ways that happens where it's literally like friends telling one another what they're working on and right. what they're into, and it's not toxic and weird and sort of transactional, right. Like, you know, there's just a genuine like, man, this thing that I love, I think that you're gonna love it. And in this particular case, I was like, oh yeah, by the way, I already love it. Let's figure right. it out. You know? And so that was really cool and special. And, you know, I just feel a lot of pride of being able to put out a record like that, that, you know, still resonates and will continue to resonate with people.
Oh yeah. I mean, I can't, like I said, I can't speak highly enough of it. That, not just the songs and Danny himself, and we ended up collaborating shortly after that came out. I like chased him down and basically forced him to be on something I was working on. I was like so obsessed with him, but the production on that and everything too was crazy. So you and I then we crossed paths again, kind of have a couple of different touchstones, but one of the other ones that came across my desk was when we first talked about you doing a remix for Good as Hell, Lizzo, which is another just like talking about music that feels good in the body. I mean, I'm going to get back to the Lizzo remix, but my question sort of is like, how do you think being like a music maker, and in particular being a DJ and a remixer, informs you as a label head, as a, you know, tastemaker?
Well, I mean, I think that being a DJ, you are, you know, someone who's an empath. You know, I think that phrase gets thrown around a lot in the sort of like tarot card kind of, you know,
yeah,
like
right.
yoga influencer kind of way. Mm-hmm. But the reality is that DJing is not about you personally. I mean, it for sure is, as far as like your taste and your sensibilities and your, you know, your technical skill. But when you're in a room of people and you're trying to make them dance, it's not about you. It's about the collective, you know, not to get too hippy dippy about it, but it's the spirit of the room, you know? And so ooh. I think that like as a DJ, it, you know, especially, you know, as you do it for year after year, you kind of understand the different gradients of, you know, certain situations and certain crowds, and even, you know, situations where you have no idea what people are going to be into, and you just kind of have to feel it out. You know, it's like fishing. You know, you sort of say like, you know what, let me send this out. It didn't work. Let me reel it back. Let me send this out again. Oh, damn, I got him. And so that you know, the sort of dopamine that you get from dropping a record that takes the room up a notch, and then the, you know, the less immediate but ultimately more fulfilling mm-hmm. vibe that you get from keeping people there, you right. know, I think that sort of DJ mentality is a real asset when it comes to, you know, selecting records to release from a label perspective. You know, it's like right now more than ever, you know, people talk about like data and like, oh, this is blowing up on TikTok, and you know what's our strategy with app X that's, you know, popping off right now. And the reality is that, you know, you don't want to be, you know, a Luddite and be ignorant of that. But at the same time, I think that the best decisions are going to come from the gut. And my gut is a DJ gut.
That's great. That's a perfectly put. I actually, as you were talking, I was like, oh, this is like such a dumb, this feels like a dumb question that a dumb interviewer would ask you, but I'm going to just be a dumb interviewer and say it. Cause as you were talking, I was like, I just got to know the answer to this. So my question was going to be like, what's the go-to crowd, you know, fucking hype record. And then my question was like, what's a song that is guaranteed to make them all leave? But even more than that, I want to know, what is a song that you thought one time was going to fucking set it off and clear the floor?
Ooh, those are all good questions. I mean, I think that for me, you know, I love music that kind of, you know, brings different eras together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and a lot of times that's not like someone's official single. It might be like a weird party break, you know, like a MP3 that only DJs have.
Right.
So Ellie Escobar is a DJ and producer based out of New York. And, you know, he's been doing his thing for many years and is very much, you know, a sort of DJ's DJ.
Right.
He made a breakbeat record. Shit, it might even be like a decade old at this point.
Okay.
But it uses the, you know, everybody's got to make a living, children work and the women produce. You know, it uses that sample that, you know, people, you know, they know it as a rare groove. They know it as like a thing from the J-Lo record.
Right.
But then he throws in the In Excess, and it's this weird amalgamation of all of these different, you know, samples from a true kind of party rocking sensibility, that the fact that it isn't a real record, people are like, I know this, but I don't know why I know this. And
right.
From a DJ's point of view, like, that's great, because nobody wants the set of just like all familiar bullshit. You know, my friend Wiz from Oakland, he likes to call it the Antiques Roadshow set, you know, where it's just sort of like you're playing like, oh, let me play, you know, Biggie, Mo Money, Mo Problems into Gangstar. And it's sort of like the most generic, like, nostalgia kind of set. This hits all of those notes, but in an unexpected way. So to me, that's kind of the perfect record. It's like, it's crowd pleasing, but it's not obvious.
Yeah.
So that would be like one of my go-tos. I would say, as far as like things that clear the floor, and clearing the floor is not bad necessarily. Like, in a lot of ways, it's kind of like blowing on the Nintendo cartridge. It gives you a chance to build it back up.
Right,
you know,
right.
I don't view it as, I don't view it as a floor clearer so much as a floor resetter.
Right.
But I can remember one time I was DJing at the bar Lit in the Lower East Side, and it's kind of like a legendary like cokey grimy bar.
Yep.
And it was the kind of thing where it was right as the era as like DJing rock songs was sort of falling out of vogue. You know, like the kind of like Interpol era of New York was in the rearview mirror.
Yep.
And I remember I played Sweet Fox on the Run, like that power pop song. And it's got that really crazy riff on the top. I think it was in like one of the Guardians of the Galaxy movies recently, but it's like,
yeah.
And I swore it was going to set it off. My boy who was with me, it was his favorite song. I was like, yo, I'm going to drop that Sweet right now. And I did, and no one was feeling it except for us. So it was like, it was a total brick, but I kind of love those moments. Like, it's way more memorable than like, oh, I played the popular Meek Mill song into the other popular Playboi Carti song. And it's like, you know, that's great. And again, you know, people had a good time, but you remember the duds, I think, as much as the, you know, super hits.
Oh, yeah. Oh, dude. Completely. I had so Nice Life, we used to have a monthly party at El Condor, which is formerly El Conquistador in LA. And I would DJ. It was very small. It's like a restaurant, super chill, barely any dancing or anything. And the last, so it was like starting to not go very well, just as far as like we weren't like bringing enough people in, and we were spending money to promote it, you know, sure. And we were like, okay, we're probably gonna shut this thing down. So it was on Tuesdays, and the last Tuesday that we happened to do was a fateful Tuesday in November of 2016, where the night that Donald Trump shocked the world and fucking won the election. And it was
Yeesh.
obviously a very, very, very sad night, hard night for all of us. You know, it started out, it was like 7 p.m. in California. So the beginning of the night, we were like, yeah, we're gonna like be able to party tonight. It's gonna be great. And as the night is going on, you know, little by little, like, oh fuck, like he won Michigan? Like, oh shit, you know? So drinking, drinking. And then eventually it's time for me to DJ. And I'm like, dude, I'm a one trick pony. I got like 20 songs. And like, I feel really good about my songs, but like my skill level is low and I just never have time to like refresh them. And so in the middle of my set, it basically comes through that Trump is predicted to win. And I was fucking gutted and I didn't know what to do. So I pulled up on my phone Jimi Hendrix playing the Star Spangled Banner at Woodstock. You know this performance?
Yeah, of course.
10 minutes long, fucking like, and just on YouTube. And I just plugged it in and I fucking put my hood over my head and just put my head down and just shredded this 10-minute Jimi Hendrix at Woodstock just to be like, I don't know, I was drunk and I just felt like it was this thing I had to do. I was so upset. And the ironic shit is, I thought everyone at the very least was gonna be like, yeah, man, like I get the art that you're giving me right now. And the ironic shit was that all the people at the bar thought that I was stoked that Trump won. And I was just ripping the
Oh,
Star-Spangled
man.
Banner. So not only that, but I had to, for the latter 8 minutes or whatever, just had to sit with these people at the bar going, fuck you.
Oh, my God. That's an amazing story.
And I went home and cried in the bath. That was election night. Okay, so let's reset. So you did a little remix pass on Real Magic. Yeah?
Yeah, so I heard the song and I got the stems and I knew that we were gonna do this chat. So, you know, for me this was kind of like a cool way to talk about how a sketch of a remix first starts. Like when I hear something, you know, how am I initially going to approach it? Because the reality
Right.
is that, you know, one of the reasons why remixing is so fun is that you don't know where you're going to end up. Like it really is a sort of choose your own adventure book in a lot of ways, and you can have, you know, a sort of intent as you approach it, but you know, as you're producing, some things work and some things don't. And like it's one thing when you're molding the clay with your own song, but it's another thing when you already have a skeleton and a sort of an existing, you know, set of pieces to work with. So, you know, with this song, you know, which by the way is really, you know, unique and amazing, and I love how,
Thanks.
you know, almost gentle it is. Like when I was listening to it, I wasn't expecting it to take these twists and turns of being like a sort of like jazzy Rhodes, you know, ghost town DJ song. Like it has that like, you know, like chill bass R&B vibe going on. Like,
Right.
you know, it that almost made it harder to kind of like know where to go because, you know, sometimes you get a song and you're like, man, this really isn't my bag, but I really love these ad libs. I'm gonna turn these ad libs into a fucking banger. You know what I
Yes,
mean?
yes,
Like
yes. Right. Make it
one of
something you li actually like is a common route.
and totally reconfigure it. Like
Right.
I think one of the greatest remixes of all time, Armand Van Helden did a Tori Amos remix
Whoa.
of Professional Widow. And it's like when you listen to the original song, it's this, you know, just it's Lilith Fair, you know, fire, but it's not a club record in any way. And the fact that Armand heard this one little vocal riff and was like, okay, cool, I'm gonna fuck it up and make like this iconic house song, you know, that's really amazing to me, and something that I always try to keep in mind. But this was not one of those situations. Like, I'm listening to the song, it's like, man, I really like this, I don't want to like fuck it up by trying to be over the top. So, you know, when I'm listening to it, my first approach was like, you know, I'm from Jersey originally. I love Jersey Club. I was kind of hearing almost like a prom Jersey Club vibe, ooh, if that makes sense. You know, like just sort of like keep it sort of chill, but, you know, be respectful of again, like the gentleness and the melody of the record. So when I opened up the stems, I was like, I really just want to keep the Rhodes and the vocals, but maybe, you know, start chopping the vocal into something else. So, you know, again, like in the initial sketch, it was just sort of like, all right, cool, I got the stems laid out. This is like step one of however many to go from, you know, parts to a finished track.
Right. Oh man. Awesome. Well, I am stoked to check it out. We have it all pulled up here. I think I have all your stems. I have, so to the people in the chat, I have not heard this yet. It's so what we do, Nick, on Mondays, we do we'll like do this thing we call a thoughtful roast, where we'll bring in like a demo from like a random person, and the shit we get is always actually like really good, and we're just really nice, and we have a very nice, gentle, thoughtful discussion of what we hear. Thursdays, we usually don't get to do any listening. Usually I just am doing music making. So we're going to let the people in the chat hear this. This is a, it's nice. This is like just a little 45-second sketch mood board, if
you will. The snares are definitely too aggressive than they need to be. But that's the kind of thing you fix at step two.
Right. Totally. This is a rhythmic sketch. Let's have a listen. We're gonna check it out. I think I have it all. Oh, actually, my busing is off. There we go. That should do it. Okay. Here we go. We're gonna drop in 45 seconds of a remix sketch from Nick Catchdubs.
Higher than you ever been, ever seen. Real talk, this I love you more than everything. Let it breathe, let it all feel alright. Different when we wake up to every night. Put it in the music on your downtime. Real magic happens every once in a while. Put it in your music on the downtime. Real magic happens every once in a while.
Awesome, dude. Oh, that was
so that's
great.
That's where it was leading to. Just sort of like, okay, cool, here's this original song that's already really cool,
right?
And then when does it go into Nick zone? And so, like, you know, starting to do those edits, and you know, that's the kind of thing where it's like, you know, if I was going to develop it further, it would make it less like just generic glitchy effect, but more like, how does this have a rhythm unto itself? And then, then what's the B section, you know, how does it resolve? Like, how is it fun for people dancing? Like, where do I put the little bit where I mix out into another record, you know?
I mean, like, after that little build, I definitely am hearing, I'm hearing a couple things. My first thought that I heard was like, wow, going halftime would be super interesting. Like, you could kind of, it really almost to me is like, go up or go down from here.
And the thing with the song is that, you know, when I'm listening to it, you know, the lyrics themselves are really affecting in a beautiful way. And so, you know, for me, my first instinct is to almost like go away from the lyrics and the song structure and really just play on like the textures of that vocal, which are really cool and interesting, and the sort of, you know, the cool little things that are happening with the melody, like, you know, that Rhodes riff is so cool. It's sort of like, man, what does the like, you know, club version of that sound like? What synth would I layer underneath it?
Right. That's just great. I mean, the I have actually, let me see if I can pull this up. Are you hearing that? It might be super loud. Make sure I'm not killing everybody here. Something that could be interesting when I, like, if I'm being honest, one of the things when I made this song that I felt a little bit, I don't know if insecure is the right word about, but like just felt that like kind of nagged at me, was how eighth notey, 16th notey, like kind of gritty it felt. Where her vocal definitely is like a little bit polyrhythmic. The bass is a synth bass part played by Nate Mercero. So that's also not gritty. That's like, you know, human feeling, but still the drums, that kind of feel in the drums nest is obviously going to be sort of by necessity, like very quantized. But when I heard your build up there, I was like, man, it'd be cool to almost have a, like a, something with a tri, like a triplet feel would really, like my, I, so I'm, when we wrap up, I'm going to just fuck with this for a little bit on for the rest of the stream, but either something that is like really surprising and goes down to a halftime, which would be cool, or like a, like a, almost like a West African kind of polyrhythmic thing would be.
Yeah, that's dope.
Like a digga, you know? I have some, this is awesome. I know that I love it because like, as soon as it was going, I was like, oh, okay, I want to get it going. Getting stoked. Man, well, dude, I am so glad that you came through. Frankly, pretty honored. When my team was like, yeah, he's down, I was like, oh God, really? Awesome.
No, this is fun.
Yeah. I'm really, really glad to have you. And I got to say, like, when I just browsed through your guys' wiki earlier and was reminded of how many things you were a part of that were so, so important to me, like at a really, really pivotal time when I was like touring with Wallpaper, I was looking at it here, like, I mean, artists that were so influential on me, like Chromeo, the Duck Sauce Project. I did a show or two with Flostradamus, obviously Danny Brown, A-Track, like there's just so much. Fucking Kid Sister, dude. I did like a bunch of shows with her. Like, you're just, this whole world that you built was really, really important and really influential to me. And I'm just honored to have you and really appreciate your contributions, so to speak.
Awesome, man. Well, thank you. No, we're all just doing our little pieces of a much bigger puzzle, you know? And I think it's really cool seeing all of the different young artists that are coming out on Nice Life, like, you know, I'm getting put on to stuff. And I think that that's like the greatest conversation we could be having. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, just like you said earlier, here's something I love that I think you'll love. Here's something you love that you think I'll love. That's it. It's that simple. Dude, well, awesome. Again, thanks again. Really appreciate having you. And I'm going to fuck around with this remix for a few minutes.
Awesome, man.
All right, peace. Take care. I'm back. Did that work? Let me know if you can see me. I was so excited. I was fanning out so hard that I signed off. Am I back? Oh, Jesus, that was... Woo! Okay, great. So, also, A-Track, if you're still in the chat, dude, coming through this chat, I'm fucking honored, man. Thank you. Instrumental in making and bringing to the world. So thanks to you as well. True OGs. Okay. So let's listen to his sketch one more time.
Higher than you'll ever be and ever see. Real talk, this I love you more than everything. Let it breathe, let it all feel alright. Different what we wake up to every night. Put it in the music on your downtime. Real magic happens every once in a while. Put it in your music on your downtime. Real magic happens every once in a while.
I got a feeling about the triplet vibe. Yeah, we're gonna get into it. Okay, so the few things I knew in advance is that his remix is at 140 BPM. So I got some percussion loops, but I didn't know exactly what it was gonna be. I think what I want to do, I'm kind of like remixing the remix. Yeah, that's cool. It's really... That's what I want to mess with. So, how I actually first got on the map as wallpaper was doing remixes. One of the first ones that I ever worked really hard on was for MIA, her song Boys. Flipped it a little too hard. I made the rhythm so crazy that when I waited for her to show her my remix at Amoeba Records in Berkeley, after she was signing CDs, she said, come to our show tonight, play it for me there. I said, okay. Saw her rickshaw stop, had my boy Coop, who's now my friend, but at that point I didn't know him, who was opening for MIA, physically removed me from the backstage by the collar of my shirt like a tweet. Tweep? Is that a word? Twerp. Like a dork. Went to the back alley of Rickshaw Stop in San Francisco and waited for MIA to give her a CD. And didn't get to play her the remix that night, but then saw her again at... what was it? Treasure Island Music Festival. Finally played her my remix. And the rhythm was so wonky. The song Boys is it's a mostly a 6/8 triplet feel. Speaking of 6/8. Boys, how many? So I put it in a 4/4. Boys, how many? And I played it for her and she was like, he changed the drums, and she was not into it, but she was very nice for listening to this annoying kid's remix backstage. That's some annoying shit that I did. So, but yeah, I got my start on the damn remix circuit, largely inspired by people like Nick and A-Track. These guys were my heroes, and still are. I think I'm just gonna do like, let's see. Let's go to the drum machine for a second. Na 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 na. that's going to be a bit of a different pitch. Kind of start around here. Yeah. I got these two different... Let's see. Okay, let's see. That, for the record, is not a triplet feel. This is the triplet feel. But maybe I could actually, if I change the pitch of this guy. Hold on, let me. And change also where the sample starts. Might be able to find something cool. Just playing with sample start time.
Whoa.
It's a little bit wonky. Let's see if I can... Close, but it's not quite getting there, huh? Ooh, that's getting interesting. Ooh. That's cool. I just love this sound. I feel like there's a... I mean, that's also pretty sick. Really, I know I'm kind of stuck on my triplet idea, but that's pretty dope. Ah. Aha. Yo! So maybe like... So this is going to be pretty polyrhythmic up against the vocal. But I'm going to try it. So obviously this is a 16th note grid. So to get triplets, you have to nudge things around pretty significantly. It's not very scientific. That's pretty close. Yep, that's not a great sound for this. Maybe something more interesting. Huh. That's pretty cool. Ah. And that could be pitched depending on where we're at with... Let's drop in here for a second. Yeah, so I want to change the pitch of that. Let's hear it with just the Rhodes for a second, just to get our high pitch thing in key. Yeah. What about It's interesting. It's not. Something could be cooler. I think the 4 on the floor kick drum is holding it back a little. Yeah. Interesting. See what the sort of combination sounds like with. Drop something this crazy, and it is crazy. You would maybe want to do it after this buildup. So, like, for example, so this is like really solidly. And even that's too way too busy. You know, that's way too busy. Oh, it might be sick though. Hold on. Wait, this could be.
Wow.
Like.
Wow.
so you could do triplets on that. But then she goes and starts to go to 16th note. So lose the triplets there. Hold on. So maybe what the move is for this pat, this sound, which I love, maybe it's, yeah, let's try, let's try starting with those triplet buddies like this. Pattern for a second. Almost have like triplet feel for the first half of it, and then boom, bop, bop, that sort of signature Jersey Club thing. Like this enough to break it out into a longer pattern. I want to like a hold on, let me just get this drum. Hold on. So what I'm doing is I'm doing a re-trigger. Yeah, dude. Hold on. These knobs are sensitive, but I'm almost there. Length, let's see, eighth note, please. I think someone's popping off fireworks in the neighborhood. Forest fires out here, man. Up in my zone, not wise. Not damn wise. Okay, so I'm gonna leave that out for a second. Let's see. Bop, bop, bada, bop. Kind of get an idea of just the basic concept here. I don't love that drum fill. I'll get that in a minute. So check it out. cool thing about what we're talking about here, triplets and 16ths and like the different ways to play with them, you can define that you're in a 16th note subdivision, you can define that you're in a triplet subdivision, or you can leave it up to anybody's guess by not specifying. So what I'm going to do is, instead of making this kind of like too much of a gnarly rhythmic stew, I'm just walking you guys through the way I think here. I'm going to make it so some of it we can't really tell what the subdivision is, and then drop back in. So I love his clap. I don't really want to, I'm probably going to use this clap, but I'm just going to. Mess with one on here just so I can keep it on the drum machine, you know what I'm saying? That boo is even cool on the ba ba. Just like that's pretty hard. And then maybe the kick could actually be, well, first of all, maybe the kick could be cooler. Or I shouldn't say cooler, but just like a little more interesting for this. Do a weirder one than usual. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. Also gonna keep the kick pattern simple. Feels like we're sort of outsmarting the people on the dance floor, which is bad, bad, bad. But let's hear it. There's something cool in there. I think it's even of fun to just break this fully in half, right? Like, what if that... So obviously, if we lose that bong, it's a fully different thing, right? Okay, hold on. Have an idea that is cool, like a creative idea you're excited about. You do it. It's not bad, but it doesn't drive you wild. Just let the idea go instead of like I've pushed down this path far enough. I've been 20 minutes or so trying to make this triplet thing work, it's just not happening, and that's fine. So, what does it want? So if I'm not doing a triplet feel, that means I can fully go back to his OG chop. And what might be interesting? I feel like I've fully gotten myself out of the headspace of the original song now, so I can really fuck with it. Maybe there's a chop of the chords that will that would be interesting. Pretty cool. So we're really used to that first chord being... what if we started with that? The minor. What else do we have? Let's see what else we got here. Just watching me do this. Ooh, he did this little thing. This is cool. Oh boy, we're in fucking business. Nick, if you're watching, I hope I make you proud, bro. Because this is sick. Oh. Easier, we'll just bring his little snare back. Set back up, but let me just Yep, that's what I wanted. I'm gonna bring my playback engine down, so pardon any crashing. Let me just get this say I'm wearing shorts. I just want you to know I'm wearing shorts. You're gonna see me playing synth in shorts. So be cool. Just be cool, okay? That's all I ask. Oh, I should lay down my drum machine. You know what? I'll mute. I'll just leave it on. It's fine. Gives it too much, makes it too sweet. It's like, I just realized that if you start going ding dong, it's like, cool, nerd. But if you, that's like as happy as it needs to be. It doesn't need to be happier than that. You see what I'm saying? So, like, boom, 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 boom. In fact, you may need something that almost sounds like it's almost out of key. Like minor note in here, just to like, and like, let's just see what this does. I have a, not perfect, but we're getting somewhere. Dum 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 dum. That's pretty heavy. Let's see. Boom dum 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 dum. Yeah, maybe it's even like, dum dum dum, like kind of a, instead of that nice note, dee 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 do, dum dum dum. Oh, yo, it could even be that the first note. Pretty cool, but it could even be that the first note is not. Let's see, but it's. What happens if the first note is actually what the other chord is? Let's just see. Probably gonna be lame, but we'll see. Yeah, not right. Yeah, so let's go back to you. I still feel like there's, could even be like a different. Ooh, should we get a little, maybe we could bring this in. This might be cool. Oh my friend, you are very, very late. Listen to that drag on that. Let's just hear just the drums. I took the bass out. Yep. And now this guy, we don't even need that. I'm gonna pull that most of those out too. It's all about pulling it back. I know this is a latency, but I got a good feeling about it. You stop it. Let's listen to this. Uh-huh. Okay. Okay. Bottom end. What is it? Oh boy. Okay, let me just lay this in because the latency is getting too crazy and I need to hear what's really going on. So get a basic little loop. This is not necessarily our final thing here, but I'm just gonna get it. In fact, let me start it without that upbeat hi-hat. Let's see. Cool. Yeah. That's kind of sick. Dope. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, dude. Okay, we got something going on here. Let's listen. Turn this up a little bit. Yes, I love this. So it's really it It's like like something hooky. Right? What do you guys think? I mean, what are you guys thinking out there in the chat? It's like first time, and I'm like, what the fuck am I watching? Dumbest thing you guys have heard me do on this program. I'm gonna lay it in and maybe I'll just chop it up. Let me get one more. I think there might be something here. I think there might be. Also, this time I'm gonna make this loop go for fucking ever. If you're just tuning in and you don't know what this is, or nothing for you. Clap's gotta start earlier, and then you take the clap out for those upbeat hits, and then you bring the clap back in. That's what it is. That's what it is. I wonder if I got something cool from my crazy meow meow bass thing. Oh, that's cool right there. What was I doing? Whoa. Oh, that's sick. What am... Oh my god. Okay, I got stuff. I don't even give myself any credit. Wow. Because the thing is, it's basically this shit by itself. That's just so great. So I think if you were to simply... Wow. Maybe it's really like this. Wow. I love this little thing too. Oh, wee wee. Just this whole vibe was. Can make it go with the boom 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 boom, like the, you know, the do do do. Is that a ring? Let's pull it up next to the drum just so we can see and actually have it go like. Maybe cool, might be too busy. Kind of down with it. We can live with it for a minute. So we'll take this. Yeah, I'm not going to reinvent the wheel. I'm just going to do this little bass thing. And maybe if that was a different. Those are like. Is that a knee? Don't. If it was like a different, slightly more moody chord. And that doesn't need to drop in until the hi-hats do, which are where here. Yeah. Okay. Another thing I would say is, let's see, this claps here. I'm gonna bring the claps back. Yeah, we'll just fly this around. Cool. This is about, I feel like there are other worlds, obviously. You could go halftime, but I think that'd be a little bit too slow. I feel like. Let's keep it every once in a while. Close. I feel like the snare in this part could be not the giant clap, but like a cool little like. Like a smaller. I think that's the last thing I'm going to add. But it. Maybe with some swing, my friend. Yeah. And maybe a little bit of dynamics. Let's see. So like, yeah. Yeah, I think this might be cool. Oh, I got a crazy drum fill still at the end of this. Probably gonna be way, 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 way too much. But let's see. You know what I could do? I could actually just swing this a little bit. Uh-huh. Yeah, swing pattern up a little. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We're digging it. Let's see here. We want this to be a little bit softer, and a little softer there. Okay, a little softer there. So I'm gonna just lay this in by itself one time. I think this is gonna be cool. Oh, not recording. Okay, pretty intense. That frequency is a bit intense. My headphones are also blasting right now. So, let's see. So where's this dropping in? Maybe like after the second round of the bass? Yeah, I think about here. So we'll actually lose these. I'm gonna lose these claps. Almost. Oh, there's that guy. Yeah, this is kind of a different feel now. Yeah. Could put something like this in here. Oh, I like that little one. In fact, maybe I could take, let's see, how do you do? Copy the, nope, not sound. Nope, copy track. Yes. Paste track. Huh. Yeah. Let's see what that sounds like. Just curious. I love that little stutter on the brip. Fine. I think we also, okay, sorry, you're out. Just get over it. I think we need, for something like this, you need, I think, a different backbeat. sound also. So I'm gonna do, I'm gonna layer it. Oh, that's cool. Love these little things. So aha, that's pretty cool. Uh-huh. My guy, let's try that. Small. Small can be very, very, very hard. Never, ever, ever underestimate the power of a small sound. This is... Wait a minute. Yo, you know what you could do? It'd be sick. Wait. I don't really, I'm not a good at dance music person by any means. I will never pretend to be, but I know that like layering stuff is good. So I'm gonna try something. Four more bars. Then we're gonna drop this in. I think the version I will. Okay. Let's try. Cool. Come on, dude. Yeah, pretty cool. You know what? Not great. Fine. I thought it was going to be better. The thing is, what gives you that good feeling? And every time this shit just starts, I get stoked right here. I'm easy to please. I'm easy to please. Maybe just use this as a fill. Yeah. Why not? I wonder if even it would be cool to be like, you're going, ah, da, 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 da. You're getting all the crazy, like, noise. It'd be cool to have a vocal sound. Man, I'm too long out of this place. You gotta help me with this, man. Oh, shit. I don't even know about that, man. Oh, shit. Once we actually drop in, like, oh, that could build some tension for our going back to our. I'm also gonna have this guy just, let's just give them what they want. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, not quite. Sorry. Do do do. Do 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 do. Whoops. Sorry. I'm going slow. Boom, 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 boom. Right? Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 wow. Yeah, let's just do it. Let's just do it. Let's have, can we have some fun for once? Huh? For once? Building up. Where are we going? Better without bass every time. Every time it's cooler without bass. I keep trying to do a cool bass and it's just like, it's just sick to be just like meow, and then like go away. I don't mind working on something for a long time and then muting it and this shit's way sicker, and then just letting go, like letting go of the shit that I was working on. Fuck it. I'm gonna put his sub back here too, because it's cool. Okay, so I don't feel like I cracked the code, but I feel like I discovered something great. I really like a few elements. I love this fill. I love these drums. I love this. I know that I love these things. And frankly, I'm cool with that. Honestly, maybe it can just be that. So, and you know what would be really fun to hear before we wrap? What happens if we just like have... Higher than you. What happens if you just like drop her in like on this shit? Higher than you ever been, ever seen. Real talk is the love you put in everything. Call here for tonight. Sorry I wasn't in the chat. I got excited about my drums. If you think you can do better, which you probably can, the stems for Real Magic are up on Audius. Download the shits. Come through. Show me what you got. Whoever does the sickest one, I'm going to have on the show. You're not a weirdo. Not bad. Not bad. Thank you to Nick, Catchdubs, the OG, A-Track in the chat, Fool's Gold, Worldwide. We love you guys. Be back on Monday. We got more stuff coming. don't miss a night because you never know what's going to happen. All right. Everyone in the chat, Gina, Dustin, Molly, Brad, Evan, Jeremy, Aaron, some new faces. Hello, hello, new faces. Love you guys. See you Monday. Oh, subscribe to the channel. Nice life. All right. See you soon. Love you guys. Peace.